Tim Porter sent us an email to ask us how to paint the bases of Blackstone Fortress miniatures just like you can see on the box. Now, to do this, what you need to do is start preparing for it as you're building your miniatures. And what you'll need for this is a file, but also you'll need some texture paint. And for our example, we're going to be using astrogranite debris. Then you'll go on to paint your miniature, and once you're ready to go on and finish off that base, what you'll need is a Baden Black first of all, and then you're going to need Araman Blue, followed by Thousand Suns Blue, then Baharoth Blue, and also White Scar. Now you're also going to need a little bit of Larmium Medium, and also some Art Coat Gloss Varnish as well. But first of all, we need to prepare the base, and for my example, I've got a Chaos Space Marine, and what we're going to do is use a file, because if we take a look at the base here, you can see there's actually a bit of texture to it, and also there's a bit of a ridge where the slot goes in on the slotter base there. So what we need to do is smooth this down as much as we can. It doesn't have to be completely flat, but what we need to do is just use the file like this, to start sanding it away so we get it nice and smooth. I've finished filing down the base now, and you can see it's nice and smooth. And what we need to do now is add some astrogranite debris to essentially hide any imperfections on the base. For example, the little divot that we've got in the centre just here, all we're going to do is put a little bit of the texture paint on there like that, and this will form bits of rubble on the final base, which you can see hides those marks. Once this is dry, I'm going to go and undercoat the miniature, and when we come back, we'll start painting the top of the base. I've undercoated the Chaos Space Marine with Mechanicus Standard Grey, and now we're going to move on to showing you how to paint the surface of the base. Now, what you should do is fully paint your miniature before you do this, but because for this example we're concentrating on the base, we're just going to show you how to do that now. What you need first of all is a Baden Black, and what we're going to do is paint this onto the surface of the base. And I'm going to use a medium base brush to do this, but feel free to change the brush to whatever you're comfortable with, depending on the detail that's around the base of the miniature that you're painting. Whatever the case though, be sure to thin your paint down, as always, with a little bit of water, and once you've done so, all you've got to do is apply this to the surface of the base, just work around those bits of rubble as you go. Once the base has been painted black, you're then ready to start painting on the design, beginning with Araman Blue. And for this you need a small layer brush, and what I do is start out with a line running roughly centrally like this, and then from this start painting other lines coming off at random angles. For example, just here like this. If you need a bit of inspiration, then just check out the bases that appear on the Blackstone Fortress box. Once you're happy with your pattern, the next colour you need is Thousand Suns Blue, which I've mixed about half and half using Larmium Medium to make it very thin. And what we're going to do is paint this onto some of the sections to give the hint of blue light in them. And what you do is don't paint the whole thing, just paint roughly about two-thirds like this, so the colour goes from black up towards a blue towards the end there. Next we need Baharoth Blue, and this is to trace over the original pattern, but this time make the line just a little bit thinner so it's brighter towards the middle of it. Then, wherever the lines intersect or wherever there's a corner, paint a little dot of White Scar. And finally, we're going to give the base a coat of a mix of Art Coat, Gloss Varnish and Larmium Medium. Now, the reason why we're doing a mix here is because we don't want the base to be too shiny, so by mixing the Larmium Medium with the Art Coat, we'll instead get more of a satin finish. And there we are, the glassy effect in the base is complete. All you need to do is paint in the little bits of rubble. So, Tim, I really hope that's answered your question, and we'll see you all again very soon.